hurry up spring. God, won't be long now, it'll be soon be spring. I'm fully loaded, heavily loaded on this bike of mine, heading out through suburbia to my local permission woodland, where I'm hopefully going to have a very relaxing camp. So hopefully not too far to go. It's only about a 3 mile journey out and a 3 mile journey back home in the morning. So hope you'll join me on this what I hope will be a relaxing, quiet woodland camp. I brought the hot stove with me. Forecast is for a bit of light rain, so should be a good one. Made it into the farmland next to the wood now. Actually, you can see where they've been doing some drainage work. It feels quite strange wearing a fluorescent top in the middle of the countryside. I'll be taking this off pretty quick, I tell you. Anyway, this is the bleak and draughty woodland where I should be spending the night. See what I mean by having a bike a bit heavily loaded. I wanted all the luxuries, so I brought my fishing chair with me. And if anyone's interested, it's the Avenger Pro Logic, a brilliant chair, really really comfortable. I've also brought my One Tigris iron wall tent. So I always get asked what equipment are you using. So I'm using the One Tigris iron wall tent, and I've also brought my Woods Walker titanium stove. I just noticed coming in that the landowner's done some work, and it looks completely different across here. He's took some wood out, it's an ash wood, and he's taken some wood out, and he's made a big track right through the middle of the woodland, so it gives the wood a completely different feel. Anyway, changes, I suppose it's a change, isn't it? Makes it feel like a different woodland. This is my Woods Walker titanium stove. I've had it a couple of years. I've burned it probably about 20 times on camps over that time, and it hasn't deteriorated. It warped from the get-go, but it, when you put it together, it all goes straight. And to be honest with you, it's been a good stove. It's no worse than now than it was when I got it. It hasn't deteriorated in the 2 years and those 20 burns. So I like it. It probably isn't the best design stove on the market, but I find it does the job. I'm happy with it. I put a little plate in the bottom, a little bit of stainless steel, just protects the base and gives the stove some longevity. But there's absolutely no wear. The only criticism I've got about this stove is the way the flue connects. I'm not a fan of that, but apart from that, it's okay. We'll just have to come in shouting for a bit. That wind's cold. I haven't got any wood for the stove yet, it's all set up. But just need to get some wood and then maybe think about getting some dinner on the go by then. It's 2 o'clock now, so still plenty of time, plenty of daylight. It doesn't get dark now until 6:45. We're approaching the equinox, spring equinox. I think it's called the vernal equinox. I always find that this time of year, late winter, it's a very cruel time of year for the young tender shoots and plants, because you know they're all coming out now and they're looking for that lovely spring warmth and sunshine, and very occasionally you can get a really icy winter blast, and that's what we're getting at the moment. But I can hear the spring migrants are here, and other little birds are beginning to sing, so it won't be long now, spring's just around the corner. Right, I'm on the hunt for some kindling. Well, I just found what I want. Nettle stalks, they always work for me, these do. Pick a load of nettle stalks, great kindling. Well, it's not nice out here, so I'm just securing the bike against the weather, making sure the panniers are all closed up so the rain can't get in. The bike should be okay here. I'm in the middle of nowhere, basically, on private land, so I doubt that'll be gone in the morning. If it is, I should be heartbroken. Anyway, I'm going to get myself in now, and the weather is closing in out there, and it's such a lot nicer in here. Got all the wood in, just got to get the fire lit, put the inner nest up, put my sleeping stuff all in there, and maybe think about getting some food on the go. Certainly thinking about getting that fire lit. It's cold. This lovely fire steel was given to me by a local lad, Kevin, Absolutely fantastic. I think Kevin watches the channel. If you do, if you're watching this, Kevin, thanks so much for that. I've used it a few times, as you can tell. But it's an ideal scraper to scrape candle wax. This is what I'm doing now. Onto my tinder. The nettle stems. And as the nettle stems burn, they burn quite quickly. But the candle wax just prolongs that and gives it a chance for the other kindling to catch, and then the main fuel. Yeah, look at that, look. That can go into the stove. It's pretty miserable out here, isn't it? Just drizzling. I've laid the bike down so it's close to the tent, and highly unlikely anyone's going to come past, but if they did move it, the chances are they're going to get it tangled up in the guy lines of the tent and I'll know about it. I think I'm going to shut the door down. Keep the warmth in, my feet are cold. Let's build up some warmth in here. Let me show you this whilst we've still got the light. In here. Because I was travelling on the bike, I didn't want to bring the paraffin lamp, so I've brought my Swiss Army candle lantern. Lovely piece of kit this is. I really rate this. Takes a bit of practice to assemble it. That's it. This glass is actually a mineral. It's not glass, as in man-made. It's actually made from a mineral. I think it's mica, and it does give out a very pleasant light. You'll see that later on. The other mode of illumination I've got is an Eyegol Zero, which is also an excellent piece of camping equipment. I highly rate this as well. I've got some lovely Idaho mashed potato, so I'm going to add that to the vegetable water, and nice and buttery it says, so I'm really looking forward to that. And then I've also got lovely roasted salmon fillets. Not that I'm going to be roasting in mine, but I think actually they're cooked already, ready to eat, yeah, but I'm going to fry them anyway in butter, just to give them a bit of extra warmth and flavour. Thank you. got really hot in here now. Anyway, you're going to enjoy my food. Not bad for a bit of woodland cuisine. Surprisingly good. I'll definitely be trying the Idaho mashed potato again, that's really nice. I just want to say this whilst I'm thinking about it. This tent, when the stove's cranking out the heat, yeah, it gets really warm in here, especially up here. But when you've got a big gap all around like you have, and on a drafty day, the heat just gets taken away. So I wouldn't really consider it a really serious contender on a real cold day, unless you could somehow block the drafts. But then of course you've got to consider, you know, the airflow, because you don't want to not wake up, shall we say. But yeah, big gaps all around. Since I've been lying in the sleeping bag, I've warmed up a little bit. I was getting a bit cold earlier. I'm just taking a time lapse of the candle lamp as the candle burns down. Natural fact, it's giving out quite a bit. I'm always, whenever I use that little candle lantern, I'm always impressed by the amount of illumination it gives, and it's a very pleasant glow as well. Anyway, I'm going to hit the sack now. Turn in. It's now almost midnight. The wise old owl has joined me. He was hooting away earlier. He's not doing anything at the moment, unfortunately. But I do like the sound of the owl. But I'm now going to shut my eyes, go to sleep, and hopefully get a good night's kip. And I'll see you all in the morning. Good night. Ten past six. I slept nice and warm in this free season sleeping bag. Always get a good night in the sleeping bag. Let's have a look outside. It's a damp, drafty scene this morning in the little woodland. When I was sat in the tent last night, the stove was putting out the heat, but because of the gaps all around, it was quite drafty and a bit chilly at times. And so I think really, to be a serious winter tent, that needs, I think they call it a snow skirt all around the outside along the bottom. Obviously then you have to pay more careful attention to ventilation to make sure you didn't die of carbon monoxide poisoning, but I wouldn't class it as a serious real cold weather deep winter shelter, and you know, if the conditions were breezy. But I have camped in that tent at sub-zero temperatures, it's been fine, but when there's a breeze you do lose a lot of the heat. Apart from that, I still like it. It's a great shelter. Right, let's get some coffee on the go. Decided to use my old MSR pocket rocket for the morning brew rather than light the stove. It'll take a good hour or two for the stove to cool down, so this is more convenient.
go.
Didn't have it topped down. Though.
Hurry up, spring. Come on, won't be long now, it'll be soon be spring.
Cheers, it's wet and warm. So that's it, the end of the camp in time-honoured fashion. I've cleared all the area where I was and I've made it look as though I never even pitched there. Leave no trace, in other words, and then you're always welcome to come back. Bike's all packed up, so now just a matter of cycling the 2.5 to 3 mile back home. In time to give the dogs a walk, no doubt. So thanks for watching the video, hope you've enjoyed it. I'll see you on the next one. Bye for now.
Oh.